First, I contact the Martell Group. I ask to officially join them. I start attending the meetings that are open to the public. Anyone can walk in on those at any time. They give frequent lectures on basic science to help educate people, so there's nothing suspicious about attending those. And I always make sure to strike up a chat with someone working there. I make sure not to miss a single meeting. That should at least give a positive impression. In fact, Martell welcomes me with open arms. Now I just have to make a name for myself. Even without the key, the familiars around Kazamatsuri are getting more active now that the Harvest Festival is approaching. Guardian needs to do a little something, if only to send a message to Gaia that they're still around. So apparently some kind of operation is going to be coming up soon. But it's only April, we have a while before that happens. For the time being, I get assigned to a patrol team. I do really love Japanese hotels, but eventually that does get a bit too inconvenient. So I rent a room under the name Kazamatsuri Bond. Esaka-san is my guarantor, so I can't do anything crazy with the place. I prepare two other safe houses under different names. They should be useful if my plans don't work out. There's no good way to get firearms, but I gather as many other devices as I can. When I have spare time, I jog. Running only 40 or 50 kilometers at normal human speed isn't much of a workout for me, but it at least keeps me from getting rusty. While I have the chance, I memorize all the important buildings, transportation routes, power lines, sewage pipes, and other geographical details. I feel more emotion from random streets around town than I did in entire foreign countries. I never used to love Japanese scenery, but Kazamatsuri looks beautiful to me now. I find a building that wasn't here 4 years ago. A multi-floor structure with greenery running up the walls, something you'd only see in Kazamatsuri. The enormous plot of land around it has nothing but grass, and I don't see any cover to hide behind. Even at night, I'd have trouble sneaking in there. Upon further investigation, I learn it was built with Martell funding. Apparently, they were going to make it a public building, but due to various design problems, that plan got shelved for a while. Since the city is wealthy, everyone ignores that. If this was anywhere else, a waste of money like that would be scandalous. Still, the building itself is clearly complete, and it shows signs of being used. The gate is locked. There are guards here too.
ガイア主義活動のために用意させた建物じゃないだろうな。
I become an official researcher in the Martell Group. They call you a student if you attend to the meetings regularly. While a researcher is anyone working for them as an official member. That doesn't mean I'm a guardian yet. I'm still on the starting line. I'll have to show them what I'm made of before I'll get to see any of their secrets. What it takes to be a guardian. Namely, dissatisfaction with the world. It's hard to live. The world is painful. Summoners tend to think that way, so I need to prove I feel that way myself. An isolated location deep in the forest. That's where she spends most of her time now. I guess someone born from nature feels calmer within it.
Kagari, iruka?
Machiwabimashita.
Kagari is lowered down from the sky by her ribbons.
なんつう登場。状況がまるで動いていません。今まで何をしていました?その報告をしに来たんだ。
I explain what I've been doing.
大きな動きはないが、仕込みはうまくいってる。今のところ、まず順調と言っていいはずだ。何しろ大事なんでな。そう簡単にはいかない。
いつになったら、闘争は解消されると
何とも言えない。数年以内に対極に迫れるかどうか。
愚かなホモサピエンス。
な、何？
うつけと言いました。
The sudden insult leaves me lost for words.
時間がないことはすでに説明したはず。なぜ悠長に構えるんです。
聞いたけど、そんな一瞬で争いをなくすことなんてできないだろう。
それをやらねば星も人も破滅するだけ。
それも聞いたさ。けどわからないんだ。あんたの説明は抽象的すぎて。あんた以前のカガリだった時の記憶は持っているのか。
いな。このカガリはこのカガリであり、他のカガリとは異なります。カガリとは現象のようなものと心得なさい。
以前のカガリが大きな破壊を引き起こしたという記録がある。一つの国が消滅したって。
最新化が起こるにあたり、今の命はその結び目を解かれる。そのようにして命を取り出し再び活用するためです。
命のリサイクルみたいだな。
That's not a pleasant thought.
なあ、なぜ最新化というのは起きる？
星の記憶は永久に良いものでなければならない。それが叶わぬことが明白な場合、知性はむしろ星を蝕むだけの害毒となる。
害毒だ。
故に良い記憶の供給が滞った場合、カガリは生まれ滅びは起こる。生命にやり直しをさせるために。
勝手なもんだな。人間を軽んじすぎてる。命をそんな簡単にすげ替えるなんて。
ホモサピエンスの一個性不全が自然現象に倫理を問うな。
She snaps at me with a harsh tone.
それは人の間でのみ通用する脆く儚い理想。人の外に出すものではありません。わきまえよ。
だって勝手だろ。一度与えたものを身勝手な理由で奪うなんて。
何一つ理解していない。
何だと？
どうあろうがそれは起こります。命とは星を包む不可視の力。生命を育み保護し多様性を与える。だが星や命に判断力などない。愚鈍な巨人に過ぎない。意志なきシステムです。知性は星でたった一つの種族にしか与えられない。人が脳を持つように、星もまた知性を宿す生命を育てます。
え、
星が持つ命の総量、有限。失われれば星は冷たい物質だけの世界となりましょう。考えるべきは人の役目、知性の責務をいつになったら果たしてくれるのですか。
けど争いをなくすなんて人間にはできないぞ。
なら共に滅びるしかありませんよ。最新化とは本来星のすべてを覆うものです。
I'm scared now.
滅びを止めるためにはあなたが動くしかないんです。
This is a much bigger problem than I thought. The fate of the entire planet rests on my shoulders. My weak shoulders.I feel terrified. As I'm listening to one of the meetings, the podium breaks and they ask for help carrying in a new one. I'm one of multiple volunteers, but just after we put it down, I trip over the microphone cable. When I do, the wristband around my right wrist slips off. It reveals a large, obvious scar. One that could only have been made with a knife.A deep, horizontal gash. I quickly covered with my other hand, but I'm sure some of them saw it already. That was an accident. So I can talk my way out of it. As I work for them, I get to know some people. Some young men around my age, and older ones taking notice of my hard work. I'm usually the quiet type. Many of the people here go out of their way to talk to me so I don't get isolated. They want me to open up to others. More and more people do that. Even people I don't normally talk to. I remain shy. I act like I can't quite open up to people. But over time, I gradually let myself complain just a little bit. Life is such a pain, there's no hope anywhere. I don't even care if I can contribute to my company at this rate. I just want to live quietly alone. It's easy to play that part, because it's partly true. When I feel the time is right, I talk to the man who usually leads the meetings. In Martell, he's called a professor. I tell him I attempted suicide in the past, and that's why I have that cut on my wrist. He's probably heard the rumors already. The professor nods generously and puts a hand on my shoulder. The next day, I'm invited here. Perfect. This is exactly where I want to be. The next day, I'm invited here. The Kazamatsuri General Purpose Hall. 9,000 square meters of land, 6,400 square meters of floor space. An 8-floor tower with 2 underground levels. The city built it for the purpose of disseminating culture, but in reality it's Gaia's HQ. Within this country, there isn't any internal conflict among Gaians. All summoners are part of the Martell group here. In poorer countries, there are some small groups of summoners not part of any organization, because poverty makes the unfortunate turn toward religion. And some small cults pass down techniques to make demons. If they attract enough people with the skill, familiars can become a serious threat. To people in those areas, familiars created that way quickly become objects of fear and worship. And sometimes people use them in combat. That doesn't happen in Japan. Instead, we have a large number of people whose minds wear out as they slave away in dull corporations. That drastically increases the number of people who can summon. The Martell group gathers people like that. There's nothing conspicuous inside the building. It's a modern building with no religious decoration in sight. It feels solemn. A lot of people are moving around, but almost none of them are talking. In order to blend in with modern society, Martell is trying to make itself appear less religious. The familiars used to be used like idols, but now they're kept secret. They still exist, though. Martell is still hiding them. In the reception room in the back, I undergo a sort of interview since I am just a normal man right now. They start with my educational and work history, my family, then ask about my personality and ideology. I know this is their way of telling if I could be a summoner. This is the reason Guardian can't get any spies into Gaia. You can't fake this. Confident, happy people can pretend to be gloomy and dissatisfied with life. Only people pressured by their lives can have such a deep shadow. Yes, someone like me. I pass the first interview. Later that same day, a higher ranking person appears. Everything about him exudes power. The last man was wearing a normal suit, and I would have believed he was just a normal employee. But this man, he's different. He's not the type who'd be treated normally in any other company. He's very short and his back is bent. His face is so dark and wrinkly, I think of a frog. He's wearing the kind of gown they give you in hospitals, and he's constantly looking down at the ground. A woman follows behind him. The man glances toward me. Then he whispers to the woman. I could hear what they said. This one's fine. He's not that good, but he's one of us. The man walks out, the woman bows respectfully, and then she leaves too. When the door closes, my face is covered in cold sweat. He was smelling my negative emotions. They're separating people based on something that's impossible to fake. I guess I passed the second interview. The previous man comes back in and takes my hand. He removes my wristband and looks at my scar with a slightly creepy smile. Good, that's all I needed to see. This man is also a serious guy and behind his mask of composure. After that, things move quickly. I'm introduced to Martell's underworld, where I get special lectures. The lectures are meant to tear us away from common sense and science. They criticize the world as something warped and full of disparity. They tell us that our worries and suffering are valid and that we have the power to fix the world. We have hope in the form of the next world. A rebirth, they say. But to be reborn as something better, we need to purify our lives. Doing that will allow us to be happy in our next life. And the way to purify ourselves isn't death, but giving our life essence back to the earth. Quite a few people are puzzled by all of this. This is stupid! You're just telling us fairy tales! The man next to me stands up. I want to end my suffering! I want nothing more to do with this world! I was told joining Martell would let me live in seclusion for the rest of my life. Despite the man's anger, the lecturer remains calm. Then he shows us proof that it's no fairy tale. A decorative plant in the room jumps out of its flower pot and walks up to the man. When it does, a woman cries. Will you save us? Are we all going to be saved? Tears of joy. Miracles are real, so maybe salvation is too. The man who'd been protesting falls to his knees with tears in his eyes. Everyone experiences pressure in their lives. Strong people may not be broken by it, but most people aren't like that. Some people release their stress and keep their mind healthy by blaming people weaker than they are. Your dissatisfaction is a natural response to the inadequacies of the world. Look at this familiar. It's a part of nature, but it takes on this wicked form just from receiving part of a human heart. This proves that our hearts are sick. But these familiars are also a manifestation of the noble wish to change the world, to reduce the suffering within it. If our work can change the world even a tiny bit and purify all future life, then how is that any different from salvation? One of the attendees clings to the lecturer's feet. And another, then another. I join them and pretend to cry too. Comrades, let us walk the path to salvation together. It is no dream or fairy tale, and these familiars will lead us to it. We begin our training as summoners. When they said training, I merely assumed more punishing exercise, but Gaia's training is completely different. We undergo lots of meditation and lectures, all within a sort of study camp format. It's meant to be mental training. At first we are all taught together, but over time we get split up based on how good we are. The skilled ones are allowed to use actual familiars in a couple days, while for me it takes a whole week. The first familiar they give us is a clump of wet earth. It just looks like mud, but we are told it's been manipulated just enough to work as a familiar. Connecting a familiar to a life. Making a contract. Doing that with this lump of earth is our first objective. We spend all day in a dark, unlit room meditating with our lumps of mud. We do get food, but there is no set sleep time. Instead, we are told to put off sleep as long as possible. Namely, until we pass out. Then we meditate again after waking up. I lose my sense of time, and before long I lose track of what day it is. Has it been a week? Suddenly, it feels like a glowing light appears deep inside the mud. My eyes are closed, so it's not visual. I move my mind towards the light. And then, I feel an invisible line connecting me to the mud. And then, suddenly, the mud in my arms expands. It expands with tremendous power, I open my eyes. Then it stretches high into the air, convulses, and falls to the floor. I'll turn the lights on. It's been so long since I last saw light that my eyes take a while to adjust. Congratulations, you've made your first contract. I look at the ground. The wet earth has stretched into a long, narrow shape. What look like 7 odd-looking legs have appeared at the bottom. It's like a disproportionate giraffe. The mud showed a bizarre muscle-like capability to extend itself into this shape. But I can't feel the contract anymore. No, it's just gone back to being mud. The life you gave it became a transient life for only a moment. Your life has now been slightly purified. After contracts, we move on. Next, we make contracts with complete familiars and practice controlling them. They give us insect-shaped familiars to work with. Now try to make them fly as far as you can. We head to the forest to fly our insects. They gave me a stag beetle with its huge jaw modified for combat. Honestly, it's kinda cute for a Yuma. We stand in a row on the roof of a building and send our familiars off. I was pretty bad at using the bird-shaped familiar I last used, but insects are simpler. Mine flies pretty far, despite a lot of wobbling. I keep flying it until it's too far away for me to control. One falls out of the sky, then two, then I lose control. The contract cuts off. Once everyone loses their familiars, the training ends. That is the maximum range within which you can control familiars. Remember it well. These were relatively normal insects, so there shouldn't be any trouble if someone finds them out there. But if you're controlling a larger familiar, you cannot afford to lose it. When possible, stay within visual range of it. Where there's a familiar, there's bound to be a summoner nearby. Now I understand firsthand why that's true. Insect familiars consume very little life. They're quite efficient, so the energy they have left will let them run around for a while, and they'll simply follow their instincts. Larger animals tend to disintegrate immediately when they get out of range. But those usually have unnecessary organs removed, so that they can't even eat or reproduce. They all return to the earth eventually. Apparently, this is part of the reason there are so many rumors about Yumas in the forest. That's actually pretty funny. Sensei, my familiar died before it went out of range. That's strange. Where was it? Over there. Did a bird catch it or something? That's the area where Kagari's hiding. Crap. Some summoners are better than others. The skilled ones can control higher level familiars, but the rest of us can only handle weak, simple ones. The lecturers cover that up with words like affinity. Apparently, I'm not a very good summoner. I can't control anything as big as what Jasmine had. All I can make contracts with are birds and other small animals. And even when it comes to small ones, I'm very bad if it doesn't resemble a known animal. If summoners are divided into classes, I'd be in the upper part of the lower class. I'm not great with birds, and insects don't feel quite right to me either. But apparently, I'm good with other animals. When I try controlling a hound, I actually pass the movement test. Then, finally, we move on to creation. Making a new familiar from scratch is much harder than using a pre-existing one. Familiars have to be created before they can be used. Not many people can do that. So they don't really mind if we pass this or not. There's no way I'll be able to do something this advanced. But then, I did it. I'm shocked to see this kind of talent from you, Suzuki-san. So am I. I put life into organic materials, allowing a transient body to take shape. Even familiars need a mechanism to move their bodies around. If the skeletal and muscular structure has any contradictions in it, the familiar won't move properly. It's possible to design a familiar completely from scratch, but that requires some incredible talent. It's much easier to use the bodies of existing animals. Strengthen the necessary functions and remove the unnecessary parts. You have to give the familiar some life to make it move, but the rest of the time it can just lie in storage. Martell has a number of valuable familiars in storage right now, since no one is capable of recreating them anymore. At the end of our training, we are given ceremonial robes. Thick black robes with no decoration. I'm a true guardian now.